Welcome to GYS. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel, we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services. And for that purpose, we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So currently, we have 12 series that focus on your prelims and one series that target your mains and one dedicated series that totally cover your current affairs. So in these prelims oriented series, what we do? We basically we have divided your whole syllabus into 12 large subtopics, and we have allocated a particular day to each subtopic. We cover daily two subtopics, and in this manner in 6 days all your 12 subtopics are covered, and this process goes on and on in cyclic manner. So in a way we cover all the 12 subtopics in 6 days. So this goes on and on in cyclic manner, and we will continue to do so till 31st May. So why the date chosen has been 31st May? Because in 2nd June is your prelims of UPSC CSE 2019, and we will end this series only one day before your prelims exam. So let's start our discussion. The first question is, so today we will be covering the geography lecture number 16. So let's see what are the questions. The first question is, evidence derived from several interglacial periods is used to predict which of the following? First, climate change on Earth. Second, sea floor spreading. Third, initial loss of atmosphere from Earth. So we have to choose the correct answer from the codes given below. Let me tell you friends that interglacial periods, they basically tell you the climate change on Earth. So only one statement is correct. So the solution would be A. So regarding explanation portion friends, if you want the explanation of these MCQs, you can contact us at this email ID, that is achieveies21@gmail.com, or you can also contact us at our phone number, that is 8968426481. Earlier we used to provide the explanation, but now only we provide the explanation only to the students which have subscribed to our initiative, to our PDFs. So certainly there will be a minimum cost for it, which has been kept intentionally for the purpose of our motivation, as well as it has been kept as minimum as possible for the purpose of your affordability. So in case you want the explanations, then you can contact us. And in case you want to ascertain the quality of our explanations, you can see the previous videos. So the answer of this question is A. Let's move on to the second question. Second question is, the state of Sikkim borders which of the following Indian states? First, West Bengal. Second, Arunachal Pradesh. Third, Assam. Fourth, Uttar Pradesh. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let me tell you friends that Sikkim borders only West Bengal. On all other three sides, it is surrounded by your Nepal and China, and then comes Bhutan. Only one state borders it, and that is West Bengal. Answer is A, that is one only. Let's move on to the next question. The third question is, equator passes through which of these African countries? So these countries are Congo, Kenya, Niger, Namibia. So we have to tell that equator passes through which of the following. Let me tell you friends that out of these given questions or given options, the equator passes only through Congo and Kenya. So in this way, the answer would be A, that is 1 and 2 only. So in Africa, there are approximately 6-7 countries through which it passes. So they are basically one is Gabon, and one other is Congo, other state is Democratic Republic of Congo, and then Uganda, and then Kenya, and then Somalia. Somalia also there. So it passes through Somalia also. So total there are 12 countries in the world through which it passes. So this is about your third question. So the answer would be A. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, given below are some of the earliest states matched with their capital. So just correct matches among them. Sorry friends, this is a question of ancient India, but it has been mistakenly incorporated here. So the options are, let's see, there is no problem. So long as we are solving the questions, there is no problem in it that we are solving it in geography or in any other PDF. So here, first is Malla, its capital is Kushinagra. Second, Vatsa, its capital Kushambhi. Anga and with Vanga, and four, Matsya with Ashmaka. So we have to choose the correct answer, that which of the following is correctly matched with its with the capitals. Let me tell you friends that only correct statements are first and second. This Malla Republic, it had the capital in Kushinagra, and Vatsa had the capital in Kushambhi. So the capital of Anga was the capital of Anga was Champa, and Matsya it was I think Virat Nagari. I think that might be the answer, but I'm not sure. So third and fourth is but I'm sure that it is certainly incorrect. So the correct is one and two only. So solution would be A. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, consider the following about physical features of Africa. First, Atlas Mountain. Second, Sahara Desert. Third, Kalahari Desert. Fourth, Lake Victoria. Fifth, Zambezi River. So we have to choose the correct answer, and we have to arrange them from north to south. Let me tell you, friends, that if you know that Kalahari Desert is in the south, then extreme south, then you will be able to solve this question. Obviously, Atlas Mountain is in north, and after that comes your Sahara Desert, and the Kalahari Desert is in the extreme south. So answer would be certainly A, because only it might be it yeah A. So Atlas and Sahara, and then at last comes your Kalahari, and so after Sahara comes your Lake Victoria, and then your Zambezi River. So the answer would be A. 1 2 3 sorry one 1 2 3 1 2 4 5 3. Sorry, friends. Yeah, this is the answer B. B would be the answer, because Kalahari Desert is in the extreme south. So the solution would be B. Sorry for the mistake. Let's move on to the next question. Sixth question is, Gondwana system of rocks contains major coal deposits of India. So here we have been asked that they can be found in one, the Mother Valley, second, Swan Valley, third, Rajmahal Hills. So we have to consider this Gondwana system of rocks. So let me tell you, friends, that Gondwana system of rocks contain coal deposits, and they are found in all of the given statements. So the answer would be 1, 2, and 3. So the solution would be D. Let's move to the next question. Next question is, the Zarewas, Ongs, and Santalinis and Great Andaman tribes belong to which racial group? A. Negritos. B. Proto-Australoids. C. Mongoloids. D. Western Brachycephalians. So let me tell you, friends, the answer is Negritos. So basically these Zarewas, Santalis, and Ongs and Great Andamanese, they are basically found in they are Negritos, and they are solution would be A. Let's move on to the next question. The next question is, the northern highway known as Uttarpatha in Gangetic Valley connected some of the great cities of ancient India. This question is again from ancient India, friends. So here we've been asked that Uttarpatha connects which of the following? A. Kaushambi, Prayag and Kasi. B. Vaishali, Pataliputra, and C. Takshila, Mathura and Ahichtra, and D is all of the above. Let me tell you, friends, that Uttarpatha was a kind of highway that connected all of these cities. So the answer would be D, all of the above. Let's move on to the next question. If men and women have equal population for all major groups in the country, the population pyramid will tend to show A. vertical symmetry. B. skewed base with narrow top. C. horizontal symmetry. D. narrow base with thick top. So friends, if you have read about your population pyramids, that the answer then answer would be A, vertical symmetry, because if men and women are equal, then there it will the your this population pyramid will show vertical symmetry. So the answer is A. Let's move on to the last question of the day, the 10th question. The 10th question is, the objectives of jute technology mission is are: first, reduce jute export abroad to increase domestic availability of jute for industries at reasonable prices. Second, improve the yield and quality of jute fiber by developing new varieties. Third, strengthen the existing infrastructure to develop and supply quality seeds through the public-private partnership framework. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let me tell you, friend, that first can't be the correct. First is clearly incorrect, because jute technology mission also focus on your increasing the jute exports. So first is wrong, but yes, second and third are correct. So the answer would be B. So here the solution would be B. So this is all about, friends, today's lecture. If you liked the questions, if you liked the video, then do hit a like. Do ensure that you share it with your friends, and also do not forget to subscribe to our channel, and do not forget also to press the bell icon, because then only you will get all the important notifications of the updates that we do on our channel. And lastly, friends, if you want the PDFs of these MCQs, then you can contact us at this email ID, that is achieveies21@gmail.com, or at this contact number 8968426481. So this is all about, friends, today's video. If you liked it, then please share it. Thank you, friends. Have a very